Indeed, the movies learn to talk. Sound found its home right next to the picture. Hollywood became the entertainment capital of the world. Major studios cranked out hundreds of pictures a year for a public that demanded inexpensive, professional entertainment. But beyond the studio system, there was a growing interest in homemade movies. In 1932, Kodak introduced the 8mm film and camera system. Now anybody could be a DW Griffith. While Hollywood was the stellar movie production center, there were rising filmmakers around the world. Directors such as David Lean in Britain, Sergei Eisenstein in Russia, Akira Kurosawa in Japan, Federico Fellini in Italy, and the very independent master from India, Satyajit Ray, who wrote the story, scored the music, and directed his masterful films. While Ray's films were pure cinema, a new film industry grew in India, rivaling even Hollywood's output. But in the early 1950s, houses sprouted television antennas, and free entertainment from major radio-turned-television networks drew the audiences from the theaters to the comfort of their living room. Hollywood responded with surround-thrill experiences that could not be reproduced on the small screen. The Robe was the first CinemaScope widescreen release in 1953. Big! Huge! Gigantic! The newspapers declared, Hollywood is saved! Today, it's business as usual for the big studios, and it's big business. Yet, there are more independent filmmakers out there due to changing technology. With the development of electronics that eliminate film and computers that negate the need for cutting and pasting the pieces of film together, anyone can make a movie and get it exhibited on YouTube, as we are doing now. Here is a camera we will use for our project. Let's make movies